Welcome back to Character Select, David Scapp. Back for more.
Crimen.
Well, Kowski. B-Cop says he located a green Kaiser Frazier from the hot sheet. Address is 6 West 2nd Street. Get over there and see what you
hot
can find
sheets,
out.
Hot sheets, lifted vehicles, right?
Go on!
Essentially, it's a bolo, more or less. We're on the lookout.
Yeah.
But yeah, it, usually you're looking.
The more cars we bring in, the longer the hot sheet gets. It pays the rent, though. Keeps Mrs. Phelps in the manner to which she's accustomed. I'm not sure she'd agree with you. Passionate, romantic type like you, Cole? I don't believe it.
Well, no, that's interview room. Where the fuck are we? Oh, there's the exit. Okay. Yeah, hot sheets are basically stolen, usually stolen vehicles, but it could also be just vehicles of interest in a crime.
All right.
Fucking what? What is your fucking people?
These
think
guys
that...
just maybe they just like honk if you're horny. If you if someone like put that in the back of your car somewhere.
Do I have a honk me sign? Like what's going on?
Yeah, yeah.
Alright. I don't remember this case at all. Actually. I remember the next case, but not this one.
They're calling her the Dahlia now. Wonder what Veronica Lake makes of that one.
The what?
You hear whether they're making
the
any
Dahlia.
Progress?
The Black Dahlia murders.
Yeah, yeah.
Captain Donnelly seems to think they have it all wrapped up. Brown and Green are sweating this Manly character. I heard it'll be in front of a grand jury by next week.
Manly!
Terrible enough being murdered like that without having been dead. Strewn all over the front.
I'm fucking, I'd be too dead to give a shit.
But yeah, the Black Dahlia murders were
great band.
Well, yeah, were a very big deal in the late 40s. It was one of the first well-publicized serial murders in the U.S. Not one of the first well-publicized serial murders. That was Jack the Ripper.
Oh, but that would be Jackie.
Yeah. Alright, what do we got here? So we're looking for a stolen vehicle, eh?
That's the car, Cole. Just pulling out of the drive. Get it!
Oh, that's a stolen car? Oh, we're gonna stop
it. That was fucking easy.
Remember, we need him healthy enough to answer questions.
Healthy enough.
1247, Detective Phelps. Requesting
we don't have a gumball? God damn it.
In pursuit of a stolen green Kaiser Frazier from 6 West 2nd Street.
You actually can't fail this.
Yeah, he crashes on his own eventually.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
Oh, jeez, that hook came right
off.
That
was a good fucking hit. I mean, you were a full clap.
Not my fault if I didn't hit it.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
Oh, no, the benches. Oh, the post boxes are expensive.
That wasn't a post box. It's a garbage can.
Was that? Oh.
Oh,
sorry. That's
whoa.
Just a Britishism right there.
Oh, fuck.
The get hell? Bracelets on it, Phelps. I'll call it in.
Out of the car. Out of the car.
Out of the car now.
Why did you run from us?
I saw a big car in my rearview mirror with two tough guys bearing down on me. What would you do?
What's your name?
Cliff Harrison.
You're the fucking sirens.
For what? What are you talking about?
Nice try. I'm talking about the car being stolen.
You're out of your mind. I bought the car, and I've got the paperwork to prove it.
Cliff Anderson, 66
like
West.
Questions for the people at Coombs Automotive.
Kaiser Frazier, type my hand.
Radio lighter. $24.50.95. Wow, cars are still expensive.
Well, you fucked that car to bits, too. That's an expensive car cost right there. That looks legit.
Interesting. So we're going to have to look at this fucking place. Sorry about your car.
Car smuggle ring.
Oh, well, here we go.
You purchased this car from Coombs Automotive Company?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, it seems pretty truthful. Yeah, okay.
And the ownership papers?
From the same place.
Who? He's got a pink slip.
If this is a forgery, it's top notch. This will need to be traced.
So this is, for anybody that's not familiar with a pink slip now, this is your registration, essentially. Or your title, I guess, to the vehicle. You don't normally...
It literally says that at the top right there.
Yeah.
This certificate is evidence of legal ownership of vehicle it describes.
You don't generally carry it on you, though.
I mean, he just bought it, so he would be carrying it.
I suppose.
You have a criminal record, Mr. Harrison?
No, nothing like that.
He's looking...
What's the blinky shit? Doubt.
We're gonna make this hard on you.
I didn't steal the car. I ran because I've got some wacky backy in the glove compartment.
How much, Cliff?
One reefer.
We'll let it slide. You're in enough trouble.
Well, that was surprisingly cool of you.
Who did you deal with at Coombs Automotive?
The owner, Richard Coombs.
Okay.
Alright, is he gonna blink like fucking crazy again? No, okay, he's not gonna go insane with the blinking.
Alright, so...
And he made out the bill of sale personally?
Of course he did! He kept a facsimile for his records. Check with him!
We're going to get to the bottom of this, Harrison. Until we do, you're going downtown.
You gotta be kidding me! I'm getting arrested for buying a goddamn car?
No, you're getting arrested.
Legit, Harrison, you'll be out soon.
You're getting arrested for letting us beat the shit out of your goddamn car.
Bag his possessions as evidence, and have him arraigned for Grand Theft Auto.
Right, Detective.
Do you know who my father is?
We need to get to Coombs Auto and check out Harrison's story.
My very favorite... patient. Well, I was going to say patiently parked, no longer patient.
My favorite, do you know who I am story is the test. You ever heard that one?
I think he's telling the truth.
The what, sorry?
The Some test. Of the most convincing people school test? You will ever University test?
Born liars.
No.
Usually they're called politicians.
Let's just pause so I can tell the story. Because everybody's going to talk over me otherwise. During a university exam, all the students are seated there, and the professor says, you have 2 hours to complete this exam. Go. 2 hours are up. He says, 2 hours are up. Bring up your tests and put them on my desk. So everybody does, except one student. And that one student continues doing his exam, and the professor just looks at him, increasingly frustrated. Finally, half an hour after the end of the exam, the student finishes, brings his paper up to the front of the class, and goes to put it in the pile. The professor's like, the exam ended half an hour ago. I'm not going to let you put that on the pile. You failed. And the kid goes, do you know who I am? It's like, what? Do you know who I am? No, I have no idea who you are. Good, and he shoves it in the middle of the stack and runs out of the room. It's fucking great.
Fantastic.
Oh, man, it made me laugh so much the first time I read that. It's like the
That's
kid,
very good.
It's like the kid who got 100% on a philosophy question. Or a philosophy exam where the only question was why. He wrote why not and turned in his paper.
Fantastic as well.
All right, so let's see if we can't find out what's going on with Coombs Automotive. Why?
All looked above
He's
board.
A Cooper.
Seemed like a clean-cut kid.
Well, I get it. You see some kid who's basically you 5 years ago and assume he's got to be innocent.
I'm more than happy to be proved wrong.
Hey, if he'd been black or Hispanic, you'd be singing a different tune.
Sad,
you
but true.
All this communist crap about treating everybody the same. But it only works one way.
I'm not sure that's communism.
Oh, God, please. Not another history lesson to the man who single-handedly won the war.
Are you finished?
Yes. I feel much better. We'll shake down the car dealer and take it from there.
Unless McCaskey. Plays
golf Whoa! Course, Jesus!
In which case, we'll give him a firm
These fuckers do not know how to drive.
See? I knew you weren't finished.
Oh, God. Whoa. All right, we're good. Yeah, sadly, institutional racism in the 40s was strong, much like today. Yeah, that's right, I fucking said it. Prove me wrong.
This fucking jazz is so chill. It's gonna feel real bad when this whole series gets DMCA'd out the asshole.
Yeah, well. Probably won't be. All of this stuff should be open, public.
That's the problem. should.
Yeah.
Like, well, this is very similar to another song that we've done recently. It's like, they sound nothing alike.
This is obviously Jensen Betty's top 50 lounge classic jazz hits. It's got this sting with a trumpet in it.
That's one of the main reasons I've never played Tropico again. Because apparently the beat on any song in Tropico is too similar to about seven other songs that all get copyright claimed.
Yeah,
one video got 12 copyright claims.
I have got a Buick Century sedan that would be absolutely perfect for you.
No, you took more stats. Run!
Draw the gun.
Detective Phelps, LAPD, are you the owner?
That's right. Richard Coombs, at your service. You looking to trade in a black and white, boys?
Mr. Coombs, we're investigating an auto theft. A man by the name of Cliff Harrison claims he bought the car here.
Well, some people would say that my cars are a steal. That's a joke, son.
It's not funny.
Very amusing, Mr. Coombs.
I remember Harrison. It was a green two-tone Kaiser Fraser, if I remember rightly.
Do you have the bill of sale?
It's in my office. Walk this way.
All right, I hate this dickhead. Remember rightly, he's...
Too, son.
Truthful at first.
Do you mind if I shoot this guy? He's getting on my nerves.
It's like, I get it. It's not funny, but I get it.
I gotta respect the game, you know? If someone looks at two cops who are like, yep, they're a bit auto thefts, and then you continue to clown on them, I'm like, alright. Fucking well played.
Alright, where's this bill of sale? Now, is this
there
a
certificate? Yes.
Yeah,
the original pink slip there, too.
Right. Da, da, da. So, this might actually, in fact, be a certificate of origin.
Gene Archer.
No, it's not.
46 North Fremont Avenue.
Interesting. Hmm. Reassignment to the dealer. Ooh, Department of Vehicles, printed for the Department of Motor Vehicles by the Marquee Printing Company, Los Angeles, California. Alright, so that is in effect a title. I was wondering if it was maybe a certificate of origin, but that's probably more esoteric.
Harrison's purchase receipt was legit, at least.
Yeah. $24.50.95.
Hmm.
We have a couple of questions.
Alright, fellas. Shoot.
Can you tell us how you came to buy the car?
Girl just wandered in right off the street.
I think he's telling the truth there, Captain. Think so?
Yeah, sure.
Nothing unusual about the car.
Not really my usual type of vehicle. The price was certainly right, though. Nice girl, but about as sharp as a bag of wet mice.
Did you pay with check or cash?
A check. She wanted it made out to cash, but I insisted. Man has to watch his cash flow.
That's what records are for.
I made it out to Gene Archer on the Bank of Arcadia.
Yep.
Can you describe this Gene Archer?
Brunette, maybe 25, 26. A little on the plump side, but not bone ugly.
Really? That's what you noticed? Hmm.
Yeah.
He seems on the up and up, yeah. Yeah, I'll believe him.
Mm-hmm.
What was your impression of her?
Kind of harried and harassed. In a hurry to go somewhere, but no place to go. You get to know the type.
Interesting.
Do you know anything about the company that prints these pink slips?
Nope. Should I? It isn't exactly my business.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, his face just popped. Whoa.
His face reset? That's... God.
His face textures just went whoop.
He just pulsed. I mean, true. He is, however, underneath there a reptilian.
Yeah, that's true. All right. I mean, he's a car salesman, right?
Yeah, that's... Swish. Sorry to any car salesmen
Marquee
watching.
Marquee Printing. You've never heard of them?
Marquee. Sure. They do all the government red tape. You'll find the place down on Aliso Street near San Pedro.
Oh. Cool. Interesting.
Pedro?
When exactly did you hand over the check, Mr. Combs?
Close of play on Friday.
Oh, that seems a little shifty.
We don't have any proof, do we? Yeah. So it's just a doubt.
We don't have anything. We got the stolen.
Well, it's more like I don't know if there's an American thing like they would never do Friday.
So in the 40s, handing over a check on Friday basically means that you're not getting money until Monday.
No, that part's fine. It's just whether it's like you just it's just illegal or some shit.
No.
Just out.
Why didn't you pay her cash? You knew the car was dirty.
I had an inkling. When people are in a hurry for money, always pay by check, son. Gives you a couple days to back out.
Oh, that's right. So nowadays, you can't actually write a check and then cancel it a couple of days later. It doesn't work that way. If you write a check and hand it to somebody and they cash it that day, you are turbo fucked. Because that check is now negotiated and you can't do shit. That was the case until the 90s when you could write a check and within 3 days you could say that you didn't want it cashed and nothing would happen because nobody would negotiate it for at least that long.
Cool. So
they introduced a new system in the 90s, to basically negotiate checks within 24 hours of getting them at a bank. So
you're as thick as a whale sandwich, aren't you, son?
What?
Whoa.
Fuck
I
you.
Mean, he's noticed your thighs.
This was all above board.
Yes, of course it was.
Doubt. Doubt. I'm gonna doubt.
God, his reptilian... Yeah, doubt. His reptilian flesh is sliding away from
legitimate
him.
Legitimate to you, Coombs?
I'm in used cars, son. Not bearer bonds. In my business, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Now don't come on all high and mighty with me if you want my help.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Coombs. We need to continue the investigation.
Hope you sort out your problem with Mr. Harrison. Go easy on him, son. Boy's about as sharp as a bowling ball. He's built too low. Fastballs fly over his head.
Let me shoot this guy, please. You have a pleasant day, Mr. Coombs.
I was about to say, he used like a lot of metaphors all at once. Give it a fucking break. But again, like, credits to him for fucking playing the game out like that. Hook,
but we can still run an APB on Gene Archer. Get on the horn and call it in.
Is there a blue phone?
There is a Gameswell.
Got them on the blue phone, not the red phone. That one's for Superman.
Red phone is for emergency, not police, I believe.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
If I remember correctly...
I'd assume ambulance or fire.
If I remember correctly, the blue ones are actually locked with a police key.
Requesting an APB on Gene Archer, age approximately 25.
Makes sense.
On suspicion of Grand Theft Auto.
I'll relay the information.
Messages for me, please.
A James Belasco is being held at Central Station on suspicion of GTA. Possible link to the Harrison case. They're waiting on you to conduct the interview.
Thanks, ma'am.
All right. Do we go interview James Belasco or do we check out Marquee Publishing?
Should I go to Marquee?
You want to go to Marquee? Okay, we can do that.
Yeah.
That's not our car.
Hey, what the hell are you doing? Grenade in a barrel
of oatmeal. Oh, wait, what was Fremont?
760. Sorry, I climbed in the wrong car here.
You just climb into some dude's car and get your notebook out?
Yeah, basically.
Fucking oops.
Right?
Yeah, where was Fremont?
I like to think of Phelps. Call it evidence. The guy's an asshole. You can pick it up on the pound.
Let's go with Fremont. I don't know what Fremont is.
I don't know what that is either.
Let's definitely do that then.
146 Fremont Avenue? Registration address coded on pig slip.
Okay, let's go find his house.
I think that's just Harrison's house. Isn't it?
Okay.
You think we?
It's on the list in order. Let's do the thing.
But do we need to? We already cleared him.
Uh-huh.
He bought the car legit. It's not gonna help us.
Do it.
All right.
Here's a chicken and egg question for you.
Oh,
do you
no.
think you have to be an asshole to sell cars, or that selling cars turns you into an asshole?
You've got it in for everyone today, haven't you?
I've always got it in for car sales. Doesn't matter what day it is. And why do they always think they're comedians when they're about as funny as a heart attack?
Maybe the more annoying they are, the quicker you sign on the dotted line.
just to get the hell out of there.
That's probably true.
I mean, when you think about it, car salesman.
Oh, this song, I feel, is actually gonna get.
We'll just talk over it a lot. Car salesmen work on commission, so they need those sales, right?
They do. They need the sales, but
Oh, this was Gene Archer's address.
Should have known that Archer Broad would have given us a false address.
That explains it.
We should go to the station, see what this Belasco guy has to say.
Or we could go to the Marquee Printing Company. However, I'm willing to bet that if we can go talk to Belasco, then
think he'll cave and give us more shit.
Yeah.
Sure.
All right.
Jesus.
I understand there are lights, everybody, but this is Rockstar we're talking about. It's fine. I can't imagine that this music would be any worse than what's in, like, Fallout.
Yeah, and that all gets marked.
Does it?
Yes. Literally every song on a radio in Fallout gets from fucking DMCA'd.
Well... Fuck! Okay, we're good. It's fine. It's fine. Woo, boy. I mean, given the way I drive, we don't have to worry about talking over the music.
Yeah.
We're just constantly going, whoa, come on!
Detectives, Belasco is prepped and ready in two. Another stolen car with legit papers.
Thanks.
Phelps looks really pissed off by that. Secretary's room.
The secretariat.
Are you drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked?
Jesus. I mean, of course you're drunk. It's the afternoon.
Where are the interrogation? Oh, right. They're back here.
There are signs on the wall.
I want to make homicide. You know you've made it if you can get that desk. Crummy bastard.
What?
We're good,
James
fucking stuff.
I want a lawyer. It's my car, and I got the proof right here. Take a look for yourself.
You think talk is cheap, right?
The paper is real enough, Belasco, but the car isn't yours. This pink slip is a forgery.
And from that same Marquee Printing Company.
Town is going straight to hell.
Where were you taking the car?
Blow it off, greenhorn. You'll get nothing from me.
Doubt.
Are we just straight up doubting him immediately?
Yes, yeah. He's literally telling you to go fuck yourself, and he was caught with a stolen car.
Two-time loser. If you don't give me something, I'm gonna ask the DA for the maximum. You're looking at 10 years, Belasco. Kiss your youth goodbye.
I want a deal.
Keep talking, easy. And we'll see what sort of deal you're worth.
My job is to drive the cars out of state.
Oh.
Nevada, Arizona, sometimes New Mexico. With the paperwork they provide, it's normally a breeze.
Who?
Swish!
Does the name Gene Archer mean anything to you?
Nope. Never heard of her.
Man, it's giving me a doubt there, buddy.
Look at him. We've just been to that fucking fake address that's on this pink slip.
Yeah, look at him fucking
swallowing. That's not even a doubt. That's not even a doubt. We've been to the address.
Oh, no!
My
partner. I pushed the wrong button.
I just said three times it's not.
All right, hold on a second. I can fix this.
Straight dope. I don't know no Gene Archer.
I can fucking fix this.
Oh.
No, fucking.
Hey, I got more to say.
I don't give a shit. I can fix this. I can fix this.
God damn it.
So, no, I actually, I wouldn't normally reset this if I didn't.
If it was a
misplay, honest mistake. I legitimately pushed the wrong button because my finger twitched.
Yeah.
Hey.
That pink slip was literally another Gene Archer fake, and we know that that place doesn't exist. I'm gonna make
him take me to the picture. Crummy bastard.
Crummy bastard.
James Belasco?
And yes, I have done that particular thing on other cases before when I played this game myself.
Yeah.
So
I too have done it.
The paper is real enough, Belasco. But
and almost certainly it was when I had the choice between doubt or lie.
Yeah.
Usually because I'd hit doubt and forget that I picked up evidence, sort of like just now.
Or when you didn't think that the evidence was enough to convince, or to be convincing. Because that's tough too.
Where were you taking the car?
Sure, I'll say that's why, and it's just not me being bad. I'll take that out. Doubt.
You're a two-time loser.
You're you don't give me something,
I'm the DA for the maximum. You're looking at 10 years, Belasco. Kiss your youth goodbye.
I want a deal.
Keep talking and we'll see what sort of deal you're worth.
My job is to drive the cars out of state. Nevada, Arizona, sometimes New Mexico. With the paperwork they provide, it's normally a breeze.
Does the name Gene Archer mean anything to you?
Oh, okay. I honestly wasn't making the connection when you said it earlier, but now I get it.
Yeah.
You're a liar, James.
Say that again. I'm telling the truth. I don't know the broad.
Except that you have...
fake address.
So that's why you both have the same address printed on your pink slips. She's a mule for these stolen vehicles, genius. Same as you.
Jesus. All right, I know her. Stupidest broad I ever met. Always cooking up crazy
schemes.
I don't know why those guys use her. You happy now?
I'll be happy when you're behind fucking bars.
What happens to the cars once they cross over the state lines?
I don't know. I just deliver them.
That's a doubt. That's a doubt. That's a fucking
doubt.
Yeah,
we don't have a location, do we?
No, we don't have any kind of proof of anything.
Give me something. I'll take you back to the cells and tell the whole station you're a child molester.
Fuck!
That's okay, so fucked!
Christ.
Sold in Chicago or back east.
You car thief. I'm sometimes gonna tell everyone you're a repeater. Jesus Christ.
Where do you pick up the cars, Belasco?
Warehouses. Mainly in East downtown.
That's a doubt. That's a doubt.
Yeah.
An address, Belasco. You want my help with the DA? Cough it up, now.
A place on Industrial Street. I don't know the number. You're gonna help me out, right?
Keep talking, kid. We'll see what we can do.
All right, James. We're gonna check if this information is worth anything.
And if it is, I need your help here, pal.
If it is, then we'll know you're a man of your word. And so will the DA.
You might get 8 years instead of 10.
You're Phelps, right?
Yeah, what's up?
Yes, I am. Look, can we do this later? I'm in the middle of it.
Ray Pinker. I'm with Technical Services. The pink slips are all real.
Yes, we know that.
There's only one company that prints them in California. The Marquee Printing Company. They've confirmed that the numbers are legitimate.
Someone is stealing them.
Sure. They're on Aliso Street near the corner of San Pedro. The guy I spoke to was Lightvall. Gordon Lightvall. Here. I wrote it down.
Thanks.
Thanks, Ray. This is a great lead. We'll get down there as soon as we can.
So, it's not just that they have forged papers.
Well, your what? GTA suspect, Gene Archer, spotted by a patrolman. Western Union office.
Talk closer to my face, South please. Hill.
Less than a minute away down the street if you run. Go! She won't hang around.
Hunt!
I said we bust in there and find the goddamn.
Alright, are we arresting?
Western Union office.
So we're definitely going to arrest her because we didn't even bring up the book. And then after that, we gotta look at the marquee.
Come on! Don't wanna lose her!
I would assume.
Bam, 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 bam.
Oh, fuck, sorry.
Dick, fuck!
Western Union, cashing your checks. Sending money nationwide. All right. Before we go in here, we're going to do it next time on Character Select. So thank you very much for watching. Make sure to click that like button down below if you liked it, and scow.
Of course, I hope you have yourselves a lovely motherfucking good time, and watch out for crazy broads with knives. And I suppose cars.
And me driving. You probably should watch out for that too.